Howdy, and welcome to this episode of From the Archives. Today, I've just got one question for you. Are you ready for some football? As this season is well underway, we're going to dive into the archives and examine the relationship between March of Dimes and the stars of the gridiron. While there was never a cemented partnership between the National Football League and our organization, that didn't stop players and management from getting involved with our mission.
Hi, I'm Bill Kenny of the Kansas City Chiefs, and I really believe strongly in the March of Dimes and what it works for. And it's nice that our team, the Kansas City Chiefs, would get together, many of the players' wives, and the community get together and have a function like this to benefit both the players, the community, and the March of Dimes, and I think that's why we're all here.
During the birth defects era, the NFL Players Association often participated in or sponsored golf outings benefiting March of Dimes. Our video team was usually on site with giant cue cards that players would read, and we'd then turn them into PSAs or advertisements for the local Walk America events.
Hi, this is Ron Jaworski. The NFL Players Association is teaming up with the March of Dimes for Walk America. Come join our team.
This is Art Steele. The NFL Players Association is teaming up with the March of Dimes for Walk America. Join our team.
Right. Healthy children, that's what the March of Dimes team is all about.
And more, good health at birth through prevention of birth defects.
Because birth defects can be life defects. Prevention, that's the March of Dimes answer.
So join the March of Dimes team. Help them work
for health at birth. So please,
give to the March of Dimes.
Oftentimes, NFL players would host their own events benefiting March of Dimes. One of the longest running events was the Joe Namath Golf Classic, an event that brought together stars from every major sporting league in Hollywood to help raise money for our mission.
Well, first of all, it's about the March of Dimes.
You got it, Clay.
Since I was a little guy growing up, I know I've been a part of the March of Dimes in some way, starting with President Roosevelt and Salk, and now because of my dear friends Brooks Thomas, Linda Thomas, and the last 20 some odd years we've been together working with the March of Dimes with the help of our friends, because we all believe and know how fortunate we are with our health, and we know about premature births, we know about children and family. We have the empathy and the compassion to want to help. And we know the March of Dimes has been helping people, what, 1954 or something, when I was a younger guy too. So we're all just happy to be able to contribute to the families, and thankfully to the March of Dimes for doing what you do.
Continuing the tradition of New York quarterbacks supporting our mission, Giants quarterback Eli Manning supported the New York market for the majority of his playing career. He attended numerous March for Babies, sports luncheons, and other market events, even recorded a couple of PSAs promoting the local walks.
Do you know the March of Dimes? The resolve, the purpose, and the drive. The March of Dimes led the effort to ensure that neonatal intensive care is within reach of every baby. Funded research to develop life-saving surfactant therapy to help premature babies breathe. Works to make certain that every baby gets life-saving newborn screening tests. Continues to fight to reduce premature births through funding research, community grants, programs, and advocacy. All for the ultimate victory.
1 in 8 babies is born premature. Many have serious health issues, and over 5,000 die each year. Let's work together for stronger, healthier babies. To learn how you can help, go to marchofdimes.com/NY.
In recent years, NFL players have chosen March of Dimes as their charity of choice for the NFL's new My Cause, My Cleats campaign. Matt Ryan wore purple cleats during his playing days with the Atlanta Falcons. During the 2022 season, Minnesota Vikings running back Kanae Wongu laced up his purple and pink cleats in honor of his son Calum, who was born preterm. Chapters or markets often held events to honor local sports stars who made an impact in their community. Events like Chicago's Comcast Sportsnet Award.
I've seen the power that a lot of this research and stuff that we're raising money for tonight goes towards, so it's just an honor to be a part of such a great cause.
New York Sports Luncheon.
I am so honored and humbled to receive this award. I am so grateful to March of Dimes.
Or the Oklahoma Sports Headliner Banquet helped raise millions of dollars to support our mission. Joining me today is Lori Applecamp, Associate Director of Donor Development in the Oklahoma City market. Lori has been with March of Dimes for the last 20 years and has a very special connection to our mission and the NFL.
Thanks for having me. And of course, anytime I have an opportunity to talk about my son and what he does with March of Dimes, I'm very honored. So I was pregnant with my son. Everything was going perfectly fine. And it wasn't until like I was in my 35th week and went into the doctor for a checkup and my blood pressure was elevated. And they told me that I was going to have to go home and be on bed rest. And that was on a Wednesday. And on Friday, I came back and they said, okay, you're going to be on bed rest for the rest of the pregnancy. And I wasn't really excited about that. I had developed preeclampsia. Went home that afternoon. My water broke. Went back to the hospital. About 8 hours later, then I delivered my son a month early. And luckily, I went through labor pretty quickly. And so the amniotic fluid he had swallowed, and they thought that his lungs weren't fully developed. But in fact, they were. But they had put him on a ventilator initially because they didn't think that his lungs were developed, and eventually took him off the ventilator. But he only spent 10 days in the NICU, luckily. But one of those things that you never forget, that's 31 years ago now. And it feels like yesterday, just from the memories that you have of having to leave the hospital and leave your child there and you don't get to bring them home. But he's one of those, you know, success stories that don't happen all the time. And it wasn't until I started interviewing for the March of Dimes job. When I first came to the March of Dimes, I was hired on as a division director in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And doing my research as I get ready for the interview, I realized that I had been touched by the March of Dimes and didn't even know it. So it became this wonderful mission connection that I felt like I could make a difference and impact the lives of other families. And again, mine was one of those lucky stories. He's, you know, grown up happy, healthy, played football starting in third grade, and now he plays in the NFL for the Baltimore Ravens. And not many stories you can say. And so it's a wonderful story. And I will say, I started working with March of Dimes when he was about 10 years old, and he pretty much did everything there was to do with March of Dimes. He would help set up for March for Babies events. He would raise money with his college football team when he got to Harvard. He served on the youth board in Harvard, in Boston when he was there. He got team members to help raise money for March for Babies. I actually attended one of the walks in Boston one year and walked with him and the football players. And he's continued being in the NFL supporting March of Dimes. So he does that through a program he calls Points for Preemies. And his position in the NFL is a long snapper. Not everyone knows what that is, but he's the center or the snapper that hikes the ball to the punter on a fourth down or to the holder for an extra point or a field goal. So what he does is for every good extra point or field goal, he will donate money personally to the March of Dimes. And then he works towards trying to get other people to match his donation that he does every year. And he puts that money towards his March for Babies team. But he has been very successful with that when he was in Seattle. A lot of promotion around that. His first year that he did Points for Preemies, he was able to get a few matching sponsors and were able to raise quite a bit of money the first year that he did that. But he continues to do that personally and stays connected. He'll donate auction items to events that I have. So he'll donate an autographed football and a photo that's autographed, and he'll get tickets to a game and ticket sideline passes to a game. But he just continues to stay connected to it. And first couple of years he was in Seattle, he did the My Cause, My Cleats program as well and did March of Dimes cleats. And so he continues to make it his mission as well. And with the story and all that he does, it's so much more to me as well, the connection that I have to March of Dimes. So it's much more than a job. It's really a passion for me. And if we can help make a difference to just one family, that's what it's all about.
Yeah, I remember when I first learned about that campaign, I would look to see who the kicker was. And I think one year it was Sebastian Janikowski.
It was.
Between the two of them, they could fund a prematurity research center. The Janikowski would, you know, like he was good for 100 points a season.
Exactly. He actually donated that year when he was there 1 year in Seattle. And so he actually donated to the program. But I always like to tell also my March for Babies team is called NICU. the number two NFL. So that's kind of a cool name because he started out in the NICU and now he's in the NFL. So it's a wonderful story to be able to give back and be able to support the mission and a great story. I mean, there's not a lot of times that you have a NICU baby that's making it in the NFL at this point.
And that's not the only thing that Tyler has done with us. He's also done the back in 2020, during COVID, when we had to virtualize the March for Babies events, he was a big player in the Step Up campaign too.
Absolutely. So, you know, everything was locked down. So at home, they had just had their first child, Liam. So he was an infant and he and his wife both participated. They recorded videos to promote Step Up because we were encouraging people to stay involved, to get out there and support March of Dimes, but do it in a virtual way. So he was a big part of that in promoting that and doing some PSAs, if you will.
Everybody, I'm Tyler Ott, NICU graduate and long snapper for the Seattle Seahawks. I'm so happy to be a part of this special day to recognize all the hard work volunteers, walkers, teams, families, donors, and sponsors have accomplished to support March of Dimes' efforts for healthy moms and strong babies. This year, this very unique and hopefully completely unique year has put forth its challenges. But this is March of Dimes, this is March for Babies. And you all rallied this year. You stepped up in so many ways.
He's long snapping for the Ravens this year, right?
He's long snapping for the Ravens for, they say, for the best kicker, Justin Tucker, in the league. Is who he's actually snapping for. So it's pretty cool. He's actually snapped for a lot of great people that are really great athletes that have, you know, are very well known in the NFL.
Cool.
And of course, you know, what's really nice is their color is purple. So it's even better. So favorite color with March of Dimes, favorite color of my grandson, Liam, is purple. So it all kind of worked out. So can't really love that.
All right, so we'll put a link in the chat later to Tyler's purple jersey on NFL.com.
Yes.
Not getting paid to say this, but if you want one, we'll find a link for it. So now, doing some research in the archives, historically, the NFL and March of Dimes never really had like a solidified partnership, but there was a lot of like the Players Association would send folks to golf events or markets or chapters back in the day would have these kind of big sports banquets. Chicago had one. New York has that famous New York Sports Luncheon. Oklahoma had the Sports Headliner Banquet that ran for 40 years, right?
Correct. Yes. So,
and I'm sure you played a big part in that for a bunch of those years. What was that event like? What was it? How do you get sports people to come to that event? I'm always curious about this. Like, how do you convince people to come to these events and, you know, and accept an award or get them to fundraise for the organization? And how does that all work?
Basically, what we did is we had a committee of people that were in the sports world, and we would ask them to vote on who they thought we should honor this year. And what it was is we tried to look at those that were having this amazing season of the year. And it was high school, it was college, it was professional sports, if that was appropriate. We don't have a professional football team in Oklahoma, but we do have a professional basketball team, the Oklahoma City Thunder. And so we would put this committee together that would actually come up with people that had had this amazing year that they should be honored for their success that they had. And we have some amazing athletes that are playing in the NBA or the NFL that are from Oklahoma. And so we're able to come up with that list, and then we reach out to them to tell them that they're going to be honored for the at the sports headliner banquet, that we want them to be an award winner. And we would have several different sports teams or individuals that would be a winner, but we would have our headliner, we called it. So the headliner was that really famous person. So one year that is a really great memory for me, I had become state director, hadn't been a state director for very long. And the Oklahoma City Thunder had actually just moved to Oklahoma from Seattle. And so we honored Kevin Durant, and he is really tall. His mom is amazing. You see always when he's playing, you'll see mom on the court there as well, very supportive. And mom wanted to be involved, and she wanted to actually present the award, the headliner of the year, as we called it, to Kevin. And she was there, and that was a pretty amazing event. He hadn't been in Oklahoma for very long, but he was very popular, as you can imagine. And she was involved. And so it wasn't always an easy task, I will say, of notifying some of these people and getting to the right person. How do you get to the agent of Kevin Durant? How do you, you know, get to a professional golfer that you want to honor and those kind of things? But very labor intensive, but an amazing event that would happen. One thing that was favorite of mine as well was we honored a high school scholar athlete, a female athlete and a male athlete. And they would fill out, we had a form, we sent it out, a letter and the form that they needed to fill out to every athletic director of every high school in the state of Oklahoma. And we would get a lot of people that would send those in. And then we had the same committee would go over the high school scholar athlete applications, and we would determine who was going to be the winner. We had finalists, and then we had a winner in each of those categories. And so that was pretty exciting. And people would call us from some of the schools and say, hey, when is that application going to come? I've got, you know, a great athlete that I think should, you know, fill out the application. We asked one person from every school to be submitted. And so a male and a female candidate. And so that was pretty exciting too, to be able to see kind of those up and coming high school athletes. But we had the event on some amazing venues. We had chairs that they were the owner of the minor league hockey team that we had here, as well as the baseball, minor league baseball team. So we had it actually on the baseball field outside, you know, in the center of the field. We brought in all of this, you know, tables, chairs to transform it into this amazing event. Greg Gumbel was there. He used to actually come and MC our event a few times because he was really involved with March of Dimes nationally. So we were able to get him to come in. I'll never forget, and I was so excited, he actually gave a Fund the Mission donation at one of the events. And I thought, wow, Greg Gumbel did a Fund the Mission donation at my event. So it was pretty exciting. And we had it on the baseball diamond, and then the same chair, we had it on the center ice of where the minor league hockey team played. So they put, you know, a covering down over the ice. But one of the things that we gave to each one of the people that came to the event, we had a blanket so that people could put a blanket over their legs in there because it was really cold. One of our 40th anniversary where we had it, and I think was just kind of my favorite one, was we actually had it on the court of the Oklahoma City Thunder Arena. And we set up tables, we had a big stage and a big screen, and we were actually on center court of that for our 40th anniversary. And it was one of our most successful years, but just an amazing atmosphere. Just like you were at a game, we were able to put up sponsor names that would go across the screen all the way around the arena, like you would see if you were at a game. There was stuff that was on the middle screen that was, you know, right above the tables and chairs. And just one of those experiences. A lot of people would wear like really cool tennis shoes with their tuxes or their dresses because we were on a court. You know, we had the cheerleaders that were there. It was just really a great memory to think about what we were doing. But we would get sportscasters that were on local TV stations. We would get them to emcee the event for us. And they did an amazing job because they already know so much about so many of these athletes. And so it was just, it was a really fun event. I still have people that say, I miss Sports Headliner. I wish we would bring it back. And maybe one day we will. It was pretty fun. And I think people really look forward to it. And a great memory with March of Dimes and how we incorporated sports into people learning about the March of Dimes mission and being involved.
Well, if you do bring it back and you find your way back to the ice skating rink, maybe, you know, take away that covering and auction off ice skates, you know.
Oh, good idea.
People want to safely leave the arena. You know, they got to pony up some cash and get some ice skates to get out of there.
Exactly.
This is why they keep me in the video production department and they don't put me anywhere near fundraising. So,
when we did the event on the arena, the basketball arena, we were able to, the Oklahoma City Thunder team actually let us borrow like shoes from the team and basketballs and things. And those were actually some of the displays, like the table decorations and the, you know, 15, 16, 20, whatever size shoe, these huge shoes that would have, that you would have on your table for a table decoration, which was really fun. So great memories, lots of wonderful people in Oklahoma, deserving athletes that we were able to honor, Heisman Trophy winners. Sam Bradford was one that we honored in my early years. He's a Heisman Trophy winner from University of Oklahoma. So lots and lots of great memories of that event.
All right. Well, thank you so much for spending some time in today's episode of From the Archives. And thank you for everything that you've done for the March of Dimes over the last 20 years and your family has done and continues to do. It's always great to, one of my favorite things to keep an eye and see where Tyler's playing, and always checking the box score for the Ravens to see, what donation levels are coming in for the week. So
absolutely. And when he does his March of Dimes, he's going to do March of Dimes cleats again this year in November. Actually, it's a December game on December 10th when they do that. He'll have March of Dimes cleats and then they'll go up on auction. So there'll be an opportunity. He'll wear them in the game and then they'll be auctioned off. So there is an opportunity if anybody would want to do that and support March of Dimes and support the NFL for sure.
Thanks so much for joining.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Well, that's it for today's episode of From the Archives. A huge thank you to Lori Applecamp for joining me today. I hope you learned something. And if you have any questions about the archives, please feel free to drop a comment in the chat. Until next time, thanks for watching.